We would be talking about the renal mass biopsy, when, that's the indications basically, how do we do that, and outcomes. So when we look at the indications, let me first enumerate the indications and then we would discuss them. So during this presentations, I would be using these two terminologies, small renal mass and renal mass biopsy. So small renal masses that are indeterminate or abnormal imaging, including some of the indeterminate cystic lesions. Then masses that are suspicious for metastatic disease in the presence of a known extra renal malignancy. Then incidentally diagnosed small renal masses which have potential candidates for either surveillance or some of the ablative therapies. Follow-up after an ablative therapy has been done in metastatic renal cell carcinomas and sometimes in unresectable retroperitoneal tumors which are involving the kidney. So these are the common indications when one would want to do a biopsy. Now, if you look at what's happening to the renal masses over the last few decades, you know, you are along with these kind of masses, you're more and more seeing masses which are smaller and incidentally detected on some kind of a sonography. If you, in fact, look at the SEER database, over the last few decades, there has been close to 200% rise in the masses which are less than 4 centimeters and even masses which are less than 2 centimeters. Now, is imaging good enough or reliable to characterize these small renal masses? Unfortunately, not. There is, you could get some idea, but it has its limitations. Also, are all these small renal masses harmless? Even that, unfortunately, is not true. There would be a small percentage of these tumors which could have the potential to metastasize and have aggressive disease. So there's definitely a need to, you know, differentiate the good small renal masses from the bad and ugly. Now, if you look at these masses, typically more than 80% of these tumors are of low nuclear grade and are often seen in elderly patients who've got a sonography done for some other reason. And in these elderly patients, there is, you know, a chance that they would die of some other competing comorbidity rather than because of the small renal mass. And that gets us to the concept of either ablative therapies or just observing or, you know, active surveillance of these renal masses. So not every small renal mass needs treatment. There is a room for, you know, active surveillance in some of these renal masses and ablative therapies. And this typically would depend on the size as well on the histopathology of these masses. And that is why the indication for small renal biopsy in small renal masses is come up. It's gone up in the West and it is likely to go up in India also. In metastatic RCC, this is the most common indication we use in India before choosing the TKI. Cytoreductive nephrectomy, although the utilization of this has gone down after Carmina, but still sometimes the decision is based on the biopsy. Sometimes very rarely in pre-surgical TKIs and often to differentiate some variant histology. As I said, in the West, the utilization of small renal mass biopsy, renal mass biopsies has gone over the decades. Some of the technical aspects, so USG versus CT guidance. You know, so it's not that CT is always better. Sometimes sonography has its importance, typically because of the movement of the kidney, sonography can better localize certain masses. It has been seen that when you combine an on-table or during the biopsy, pre-biopsy FNAC, the yield is better actually. It's called ROSE, rapid on-site cytology as or rapid on-site evaluation. Needle size, typically an 18 gauge needle is used. We would generally take 3 to 4 cores and a coaxial needle is used for biopsy. This is typically the coaxial needle which is used and it reduces the chances of needle tract seeding. Some pictures to show how the biopsy is taken. So you can see there's a coaxial needle which has gone into the mass and it has taken out a cylinder of around 1 to 2 centimeters from the mass. A picture to say that, you know, these small renal masses often are heterogeneous. So there could be an area of necrosis and scar interspersed between the renal cancer. And so the importance of good imaging and good localization while doing these biopsies. When we talk about outcomes of small renal biopsies, the renal mass biopsies, there are essentially two things. A, whether the renal mass biopsy is safe. And second, does the biopsy reveal reliable oncological information or no? So from the archives, you know, then in the 70s, there was a concern that renal mass biopsy could lead to tumor seeding. But over the years, there have been many papers to say that this is not true. There's been hardly any reports of needle tract seeding, especially when the coaxial needles has been used. there have been some complications. Typically, perirenal hematoma is close to 5%, but most of the other complications are 1 to 2%. So, in essence, renal mass biopsy today is considered a very safe procedure to be done. The yield of renal mass biopsy, whether it actually gives us the information which we need. So, in terms of differentiating benign versus malignant, the yield is actually close to 90 or more than 90%. Differentiating the different grades, the Furman grades, it's close to around 75%. And characterizing clear cell from non-clear cell, again, it is somewhere between 75 to 90% in various series. Some terminologies which we should be knowing when we order a biopsy. So biopsy is called failed when it does not provide sufficient or adequate tissue for diagnosis. It's called indeterminate when the pathologist cannot make out definitive diagnosis using the available tissue. And inaccurate when there's a discrepancy between the diagnosis made on the biopsy and the final histopathological specimen. So can we predict whether the biopsy is going to be reliable or no? Certain factors like the tumor size, whether the tumor has solid or a lot of cystic component, tumor location, whether exophytic or endophytic, patients BMI, obese patients, imaging that has been used, needle size are things which would decide how successful the biopsy is. Typically, if there's a cystic tumor or in obese patient where the skin to tumor distance is large, there's one paper which has mentioned close to 13 centimeters, more than 13 centimeters, then there's a possibility that the yield may not be good. There are certain limitations of renal mass biopsy, typically because of the heterogeneity of these tumors. The EAU guidelines do describe about the role of biopsies, and they say that before ablative therapies and systemic therapies, biopsies are required. Often before active surveillance also, if a patient is a candidate for active surveillance, depending on the size of the tumor, these biopsies are required. Coaxial technique, as I mentioned, has been recommended by EAU. Cystic renal masses, EAU says that better not to perform because the yield is poor. And core biopsy is generally preferred. So renal biopsy is, renal mass biopsy is safe, reasonably accurate. It is probably underutilized, has the potential to change treatment decisions and management of small renal masses and metastatic RCC. It preferably done and reported in high volume centers, and probably molecular profiling is the way forward. Thank you so much.